What's up, guys? Dr. Ricky back answering your most common questions on some of my popular videos. Let's get into it. So guys, this is one of my first TikTok videos very early on that went viral, and it stimulated hundreds of pre-med students reaching out to me. Something that I love to do is to mentor pre-meds, so let's answer some questions. The first question comes from John Blankenship, and the question is, were you a non-traditional student, meaning did you have a secondary career? So John, ironically enough, no. I just decided late in my career that medicine was what I wanted to pursue, and that's why I was 26 when I applied to medical school. Kai asked, did you spend more than 4 years in undergrad? Well, Kai, because I was a senior in college when I decided to go pre-med, I had to spend an extra year. So I went a full summer, a whole year, and another full summer to finish all of the prerequisites and the MCAT test to apply to medical school. The next question is from me. Not me, from me. And me asks, any useful tips that lots of doctors don't already say about medical school? So the first tip that I have for you is just get into medical school. It does not matter where you go, just get into medical school. The second tip that I don't think a lot of doctors tell you is, in my opinion, try to choose the school that you are gonna leave with either no debt or the least amount of debt. And the third tip is kind of a harsh one for some people to hear, but I often give the advice, if you could see yourself doing anything else in life, do that. And the reason I say that is because becoming a doctor is a very long, long journey, and you have to want to be a doctor if you're gonna go to medical school. Some of y'all's handles crack me up. The next question is from 7_LW_12. And the question is, how did he crush the MCAT? Did he take a prep course? All right, I'm gonna tell you a couple of ways that I crushed the MCAT. Number one, yes, I took a prep course. I took the Princeton Review and it was amazing. Number two, I did as many question banks as I could and simulated the exam by timing myself. And by doing that, I put myself in that stressful situation. So come that day, I was ready to go. Linda Lopez asks, which colleges did you attend? So Linda, I went to two different colleges. First, I went to Syracuse. I spent my freshman and sophomore year there, and after 200 inches of snow each year, I decided I'm going back to Georgia. So then I transferred back to the University of Georgia, which is where I completed the rest of my pre-med coursework and then matriculated into medical school from there. The next question is from M.E.M., and that is, how old were you when you finished your schooling? So I finished all of my pre-med coursework at the University of Georgia when I was 26. I applied to med school, got in when I was 27, so I finished medical school when I was 30. So I'm double board certified in general surgery and plastic surgery. General surgery was a 6-year journey for me because I did a year of wound healing and scarring research in the middle. I then did 2 years of plastic surgery training, which put me at the ripe old age of 39 when I finished. All right, the next question comes from Eli, and he asks, can you give us tips on how you overcame everyone else's negativity? Did you change your habits? Okay, Eli, for those of you who don't know, in the beginning, my pre-med school advisor told me I was a long shot and I was never gonna get in. And my dad was a little discouraging towards me because he was worried at how much I struggled in school at an early age, and he knew that it was gonna be a really long journey. So the easiest way to get me to do something is to tell me I can't do it. That's how I handled the negativity. I went from taking it as a bad thing, and it drove me even harder to work hard, study hard, and make sure that I got in. So if I could give you one tip about negativity in general, you need to learn how to shut it out. Put it out of your mind. Don't compare yourself to other people. If you know that you want something, you go get it and don't listen to what anyone else tells you. Okay, the last question is from Caroline Kelly 162. It bugs me how med schools or physical therapy schools won't look at you with a low GPA. How do I get in? Well, Caroline, I was in your shoes. And so here's the thing. Grades are only one small part of everything. And while they're important, you have to take where you're weak and make your strengths even stronger. For me, I ended up doing really well in my pre-med classes, but where I really excelled was that I'm a very authentic person, and I just told my story and I explained my passion for why I wanted to be a doctor. Now, I realize at the end of the day, you still might not get in. And so what you have to decide is when you don't get in or you, quote, fail, what are you going to do when you fail? To me, what defines people is what happens after failure. Do you roll over and quit? Or are you going to figure out how to make your strengths even stronger and apply again? So Caroline, the last thing that I will tell you is grades do not define everybody. Some of the smartest people I know in school are not the best doctors. And the reason I feel like I was successful is because even though I didn't have the best grades, what I am good at is I have an incredible bedside manner. I'm really good at talking to patients, and I portrayed that in my interviews. And ultimately, they felt my authenticity, and I think that's what helped me get in. All right, my friends, I hope this video helps you on your journey to medical school or physical therapy school or whatever it is you're trying to do. And just remember, if you fail, it's okay. What defines you is how hard you work. And if you know that you want something, you go get it because no one's going to do it for you. So for now, guys, Dr. Ricky, out.